Somebody told me to deliver this message. Talking about, you see the world is full of confusion.
Welcome again to Come and See Ministries. I'm Pastor Moore, and this here is Pastor Nehemiah. And today we're dealing with the circumcision of the heart. What do you mean the circumcision of the heart? This is the mind of God that you got to have. This is that thing you got to get rid of, this flesh that's on your mind. Your mind is a low within itself, because it thinks things that is not godly, and so it thinks things that's fleshly, and so we have to bring our mind under subjection, or else we would act out the things that are in the flesh. You see, so this is that thing. So we got to circumcise our heart in order to circumcise the flesh. What do you mean? You circumcise your mind, your flesh is going to also be circumcised. Other words, brothers and sisters, is going to follow the word of God. So let's look at this. Let's get into Genesis chapter 17 and verse 1. Genesis 17 and verse 1. When you get it, go ahead.
Genesis 17 and 1.
Yes, sir.
When Abram was 90 years old and nine, the Lord appeared to Abram and said unto him, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly. And Abram fell on his face, and God talked with him, saying, As for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. Neither shall thy name any more be called Abram, but thy name shall be Abraham, for a father of many nations have I made thee.
Uh-huh.
And I will make thee exceeding fruitful, and I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee and thy seed after thee in their generations, for an everlasting covenant to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee.
Skip down to 10 and go ahead.
This is my covenant which ye shall keep between me and you and thy seed after thee. Every man child among you shall be circumcised.
Now, the first thing he brought forth is said, every man child among you must be what?
Circumcised.
Circumcised. Other words, you got to get rid of that flesh. You got to get rid of that flesh. You're going to call yourself serving God. You can't hide that load of flesh on you talking about I'm serving God and I'm walking in the flesh. That's not possible. Read on.
And ye shall circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be a token of the covenant betwixt me and you. And he that is 8 days old shall be circumcised among you, every man child in your generations. He that is born in the house or brought with money of any stranger, which is not of thy seed. He that is born in thy house, and he that is brought with thy money, must needs be circumcised, and my covenant shall be in your flesh for an everlasting covenant.
Shall be what?
An everlasting covenant.
It's going to be a token in your flesh for an everlasting covenant. So look, you're going to get rid of this flesh here, and you're going to take on the spirit of God forever. This is the whole thing. This is his plan for us. So this is the thing that we're looking for from the Most High. Let's look at this a little further. Go into Exodus chapter 12 in verse 43. He said an everlasting covenant. Now, here the Lord is finna give us the ordinance of the Passover, but it's a kingdom shot when you listen to it. When you get it, go ahead, 12 and 43.
And the Lord said unto Moses and Aaron, this is the ordinance of the Passover. There shall no stranger eat thereof, but every man's servant that is brought for money, when thou hast circumcised him, then shall he eat thereof.
Same thing when he told Abraham. He said, this is my covenant. I need you to be circumcised in order for you to take part in what? Passover. But the Passover is a kingdom shot, because Jesus said, I will no longer drink of this vine until my Father's kingdom. It's a kingdom shot. You must do it. You must do away with the flesh. You got to do away with the flesh, brothers and sisters. You can't live in the flesh talking about I'm serving God and the flesh is all over your mind. You got to wash that out. Look, Don't get me wrong. We all going to entertain evil thoughts sometime or another. But the book tells us that we got to bring every thought in subjection to God. Every last one. Read on, brother.
But every man's servant that is bought for money, when thou hast circumcised him, then shall he eat thereof. A foreigner and an hired servant shall not eat thereof. In one house shall it be eaten. Thou shalt not carry forth aught of the flesh abroad out of the house, neither shall ye break a bone thereof.
Now this is starting to sound like a feast, don't it?
Mm-hmm.
Here it is. Now you eating and you drinking and you eating and you drinking and food and stuff like that. It's a feast day. The Passover is actually a feast, you know, but that's a whole nother lesson. Anyway, he said, but don't you take the flesh home with you. You're supposed to leave what you don't eat. If you what you full to the full, whatever's left, you're supposed to get rid of it. Throw it away. Simple as that. That's what he said. Read on.
All the congregation of Israel shall keep it. And when a stranger shall sojourn with thee and will keep the Passover to the Lord, let all his males be circumcised. And then let him come near and keep it. And he shall be as one that is born in the land.
Now, here it is. Now, when the man, now when the strangers decide to keep the Passover, want to walk with Jesus, man, because Jesus is the Passover, and one want to keep the Passover with Christ, he got to be circumcised. So now he going to be as what? One born in the land. So he get the same promises. He get the same rewards. Because now he is officially a child of God because he's following after the Lord God of Israel. It's just that simple. You can't get around that. Can't get around that. He don't get a law and then he get the same. He got to do everything we do, but he don't get the same promises. Yes, he do. Yes, he do. He get everything that we get because he have bought into the Lord. And he is not denied by the Lord anything other than he going to sit on David's throne. Aside from that, everything that the Lord promised us, he get. Once he's taught and he becomes spiritually Israel, it's a wrap. He no longer one considered in the world. He considered one of your brothers. It's just that simple. Read on.
For no uncircumcised person shall eat thereof. One law shall be to him that is homeborn and unto the stranger that sojourneth among you.
Okay, good. One law for all. It's just that simple. People want to sit up there and say, well, the law is for the Israelites and the new covenant is for the church. No, one law is for all. Now, let's look at this a little further. Going to Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. Deuteronomy chapter 10 and verse 12. Why are we talking about the circumcision of the heart? Because the Lord talked about the circumcision of the heart. You gotta shake this load of flesh that's wrapped around your brain. That is everything you've been taught pertaining to the flesh to dishonor your body before God. Or dishonor those that's around you. Or to treat people with the wrong intent. You got to know how to really, really, really understand how the Lord deal with people. And then the way he deal with them, he show you how to talk and deal with people. You see? 12, 10 and 12, and go ahead.
And now, Israel, what doeth the Lord thy God require of thee, but to fear the Lord thy God, to walk all in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
This is what the Lord require of us, that we do this. He said that we fear the Lord, walk in all his ways, love him. Not just fear him, but love him. And then he said this, and to serve the Lord with all your heart and all your mind, all your heart and all your body. Everything, your whole being. Read on.
And to keep the commandments of the Lord and his statutes, which I command thee this day for thy good.
Uh-huh.
Behold, the heaven and the heaven of heavens is the Lord's thy God, the earth also with all that therein is. Only the Lord had a delight in thy fathers to love them, and he chose their seed after them, even you above all people, as it is this day. Circumcise therefore the foreskin of your heart, and be no more stiff-necked.
Look at here. He says, circumcise what? The foreskin of your what? Your heart, your mind. You got to get rid of that flesh that's wrapped around your mind. You can't serve the Lord and keep the commandments of God with flesh around your mind. Your mind, your head got to be circumcised. Let's look at this a little further. Go into 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 6. 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 6. You can't take part in the Passover unless you've been circumcised, people. And I'm talking about spiritually. That's what he said. Let us examine ourselves. People think, because we taking the Passover and we good because we ain't did nothing physical or anything to that effect. No, man, you may be worse than something physical. Physical, something you can fix. Spiritual, that's a hard fix because you got to see yourself. You got to recognize that sin is in you. You got to recognize that you're capable of doing the things that you are doing. You see? But if you don't see it, all you are is just out here doing whatever comes to your mind and judging everybody else out here against you. 5 and verse 6, and go ahead.
Your glorying is not good. Know ye not that a little leaven leaveneth the whole lump?
Why? Because you can't take leavening when you take the Passover with Christ. It got to be with bread of unleavened. You understand? Read on.
Purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump, as ye are unleavened. For even Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
You got some of us that's taking leavening after we taking the Passover, and that shouldn't be because Christ is the most holy. And leavening represents sin, so you can't take leavening with Jesus. Read on.
Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with old leaven.
Therefore, let us do what?
Keep the feast.
Look, so the feast is still in effect. What book is this, brother?
This is 1 Corinthians.
That's the New Testament, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
So we still keeping the law, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
All right, there you go. So you got to stop all that nonsense. We ain't got to keep that old law. This is plain. Therefore, let us do what?
Keep the feast.
Read on.
Not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth.
Look, he said, but you keep this feast not with the leavening, which is leavening of malice and wickedness. What is malice, man? Read that word malice for us and let the people understand what malice is, why you can't take the Passover with malice in your heart. But a lot of us don't even know what malice is. We don't even examine the words that the Lord tell you these things are not supposed to be named among you. But then we just take it for granted. Oh, Lord, that ain't in me. Truth be told, if you don't read it, it's there. It's in your darkness. Because if you don't bring it to the light, you will never see it. So you got to search those things out to make sure these things aren't in your heart. Read on.
Active ill will.
Look, you taking this Passover and you got ill will towards your brethren? You got ill will toward people? You shouldn't be putting your mouth on that blood. You shouldn't be putting your mouth on his body because you ain't got the wrong, you got the wrong state of mind in the first place because you wishing evil on people. And that's sad, man, because that's what we do. We look for people to be dealt with God versus being delivered. We don't want to see them saved. We don't see them, the Lord having mercy on their sins. We'd rather see them say, oh, so we can say, oh, see, there you go, there it is, that's this and that's another. Unless it's somebody that we know and love. But let them fall off into some nonsense. Read on.
Desire to harm others or do mischief.
The desire to harm others? Do mischief? You can't take the Passover. You up here and you hurting people, especially the brethren. You ain't supposed to be nowhere near it. Read on.
Spite.
You got spite in your heart? Read on.
In law, evil intent.
Evil intentions. You got evil intentions in your heart? Stay away from that thing, man, because Christ ain't in you. He ain't in you. And you putting your mouth on this thing, and he telling you, you better not take this Passover with no malice in your heart. Read on.
State of mind shown by intentions to do or intentionally do of something unlawful.
Look, or to your brother. The state of mind, an uncircumcised mind. That's why he was telling you, you can't take the Passover with the spirit of leaven, because your mind ain't circumcised. It's covered in flesh. That's the will of the flesh. And when you act this out, you're not acting out Christ. You're acting out Satan. Read on.
A deliberate intention and plan to do something unlawful as murder.
Okay, is that it? Or we got synonyms?
Okay, grudge.
You got a grudge. You know what a grudge is? If you look it up in your Webster dictionary, grudge come up, evil spirit, a foul spirit. That's what grudge means. You better look at that thing, and you sit up there, you got a grudge against somebody, you better shake that load, because that's a devil. And it's riding you, and it's going to get stronger and stronger and stronger until you know how to forgive somebody. That's part of the Lord's prayer. What are you praying for then? You're wasting your time if you're holding grudges. Look at here. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on this earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us of our debts as we do what? Forgive others. We can forget about it. You can let all that go. You ain't even supposed to be nowhere near that. A grudge? This is malice. Read on.
Malignity, hatred.
Hatred. We're going to get into that word hatred. Read on.
That's it. That's
okay, it. Good. Now, let's look at this a little further. Let's get back to the word, brother. Let's get into Romans chapter 8 and verse 1. Romans chapter 8, verse 1. See, that uncertainty. See, you got to have a circumcised mind here, brothers and sisters. In other words, you're going to be acting out in the flesh. You're going to be doing fleshly things. And you're going to do things that are spiteful and evil to other people. And you are the ones that the Lord is going to say, I never knew you. Surprise, surprise. Better check yourself. As that old saying go, before you wreck yourself. 8 and 1. When you get it, brother, go ahead.
There is, therefore, now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death.
Look, man, this is what happened with the Word of God. It'll set you free, but you got to want to be free, man. But we don't want to be free. We love this world, and that's truth be told. We love this world. We love everything in it. We love the music, the entertainers, and all that, and all their wickedness. We love all the stuff that they doing. We even keep up with their nonsense in this world like it's something to even behold. So we pay more attention to them than we do the Word of God. We know more about them than we do the Scriptures. Read on.
For what the law could not do in that it was weak through the flesh, God sent in his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh, and for sin condemned sin in the flesh, that the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Read on.
For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit.
Look here, and they ain't talking about just the Word of God. The things of the Spirit is the law. You mind things of the law, things that pertain to the law, and you're trying to keep those things. And so from Genesis to Revelation, these are the things that you're concerned with. These are the things that's on your mind. You don't really have time or room for anything else when these things are on your mind, because these things are our treasure. You understand? You don't have time for stats of NASCAR and hockey and basketball and baseball and football and the Word of God. You ain't got time for that. Your treasure is where your heart is. You ain't got time for stats in the stock market and all this other stuff that pertain in the world. Unless that's your livelihood. But then once you get done with your livelihood, you better get with this Word. Read on.
For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace.
So the Lord is telling me here that if I keep his laws and statutes, it's going to bring me what?
Life and peace.
Peace. Peace. Peace of mind. That's what you want. That's what you want from the Lord. Read on.
Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God.
Why? Because they aren't circumcised. They are in the flesh. They're not circumcised before God. So they can't please God. Therefore, they can't take part in Jesus. They can't take part in the Passover. Matthew chapter 15 and verse 7. Matthew chapter 15, verse 7. When you get it, go ahead.
Matthew 15 and 7.
Yes, sir.
Ye hypocrites, well did Elias prophesy of you, saying, this people draw nigh unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their hearts is far from me.
Because their heart is flesh. Their heart is far from God. He said, you hypocrites. He ain't talking to the world, is he? He's talking to those of us that's in the Word. He ain't talking to the world because the world don't care about this book. The world don't care about the Word of God. The world, even the world that's out here as we know as the religious secular world, they don't care nothing about this. But he's talking to us. He's talking to those. Remember now, he was talking to the Pharisees when he said it, didn't he? He was talking to the children of Israel, the church. He was talking to the church. Listen, stop putting his face on people that's not around you. Stop putting his face on the outside of your walls. No, sir. He's talking to the camp. Understand this. So he can get us straight, man. So that we can be ready when he's coming. Read on.
But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandment of men.
Read on.
And he called the multitude and said unto them, hear and understand. Now that which goeth unto the mouth defileth a man, but that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth a man. Then came his disciples and said unto him, knowest thou that the Pharisees which offend after they heard this saying?
You hear a lot of Pharisees get offended when they hear the truth. But that's what it is. It's going to be that way sometimes. Oh well. Skip down to 15 and go ahead.
Then answered Peter and said unto him, declare unto us this parable. And Jesus said, are ye also yet without understanding? Do not ye yet understand that whatsoever entereth in at the mouth goeth unto the belly and is cast out unto the draught? But those things which proceedeth out of the mouth cometh forth from the heart, and they defile the man.
Look, man, everything that come out of your house or your mind, I should say, is what defile you. That's that thing. That would make you uncircumcised. That would make you a child of the flesh, because you're not talking about the things that's pertaining to life. You're talking about the things that's pertaining to death. You are of that hue. You are of that being that's trying to kill, steal, and destroy. You're that person. Because you ain't talking about the kingdom. You ain't talking about those things that are pertaining to life to those who need it. You only selling life to those who you think need it. Let's look at this a little further. Go into Genesis chapter 6 and verse 1. Genesis chapter 6 and verse 1. This is a headbanger here. Because this is what's going on with us today. And I got to read this. And I'm telling you, man, this is what's happening with Israel today. I'm talking about my brothers. I'm talking about my brothers that know they're Israelites. I'm talking about what part of the world you're from. I'm talking about all of y'all. Here, we got this problem. Read on.
And it came to pass when men began to multiply on the face of the earth and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw that the daughters of men, that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose.
Oh, man, I got me a Beyonce. You understand? I got me a Madonna. I got me something off of that reflection. The daughters of men. So now you got these daughters of men that don't know your God, who won't serve your God, but you went out there and you done married you somebody that don't care about Jesus. Don't care nothing about the Holy Spirit. Don't care nothing about the Father sitting next to him. None of those laws and statutes that he brought forth before the creation ever was. All they care about is this world. And now you got to cater to her because you got to be in the world with her. Guess what? Now you drug down into the world. Read on.
And the Lord said, My spirit shall not always strive with man, for that he also is flesh, yet his days shall be 120 years.
Now look, now here it is. Now he started cutting down his lifespan. Skip down to 5 and go ahead.
And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thought of his heart was only evil continually.
Now this is what's happening. Now once this son of God run up on this daughter of man, now his heart started changing, and he started laxing in the things that are spiritual. And he started laxing in the things that pertain unto the king and his throne. And so now we live in according to the world, which is going to be destroyed. And chances are, if we don't get our acts together, we're going to be destroyed with it. It's just that simple, just that plain. And there ain't nothing else left about it. He said, but the imagination of man is what? He said he saw the wickedness of man is what?
Evil continually.
Evil continually. Read on.
And it repented the Lord that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And
it grieved him. And this is a sore thing unto the Most High. We got this thing, but we created in his image. You understand? Let's look at this a little further. Let's go off into Genesis chapter. Now skip down. Skip down to verse 11 and go ahead.
11. The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence.
Now we're looking at the world now. Look at this world now. It's filled with what?
Violence.
And corruption. It is. We back to the days of Noah, and we so used to it, we so numb to it, it's not affecting our spirit because we're not even trying to address the Holy Spirit. We're busy trying to survive in a world that's full of corruption instead of trying to separate yourself from it. Read on.
And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth.
How absolute is all flesh? All the sons of God was gone, wasn't he? Read on.
And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth.
Okay, good. Let's look at this a little further. Go into Genesis chapter 8 and verse 20. Now he did it, and now he's finna tell Noah something. Genesis 8 and 20. When you get it, go ahead.
And Noah built an altar unto the Lord and took of every clean beast.
What? Took every what?
Clean beast.
Dietary laws. You see the dietary laws there? Took every what?
Clean beast.
When you look at what's clean, you go and look in Leviticus chapter 11 and Deuteronomy chapter 14. He'll tell you what's clean to the Lord. So he offered that which is clean, not pork, not pigs, not geese and gooses and things of that nature. Read on.
And of every clean fowl, and offer burnt offerings on the altar. And the Lord smelled a sweet savor, and the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake.
Man, you know what? You can pray to the Lord and he'll say something. He may not say it to you because he didn't say this to Noah, did he? He said this in his what? In his heart that I won't destroy man. So sometimes the Lord will repent himself in his own self. Read on.
For the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth. Neither will I again smite any more everything living as I have done.
Okay, go into Galatians chapter 5 and verse 13. Because he said this. He said, the imagination of man is evil from his youth. From his youth. But then again, you got to learn how to walk before the Lord. You got to learn how to be righteous before our King. And so he teaches us that. But then again, you can mess around and you can find yourself someone out here in this world and they'll take you away from that thing. They'll take your spirit from you. They'll steal your crown because they're not sent from God. Then ask David about Michal. Ask him about that because Saul said, let her be a breach in your spirit. You need to really read about our kings and what these men had in store for them, the righteous against the wicked against the righteous. 5 and verse 13, and go ahead.
For brethren, ye have been called unto liberty. Only use not liberty for an occasion to the flesh, but by love serve one another.
But by what?
Love.
Serve one another. You got to serve one another. You got to be willing to let go, and then you got to be willing to humble yourself and serve somebody else that you think that's beneath you. Read on.
For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Uh-huh.
But if ye bite and devour one another, take heed that ye be not consumed one of another.
Look at here. You can bite and devour one another, but then you can turn around and destroy one another with that. Read on.
This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh.
If you keep the commandments of God, you walking in the Spirit, man. You're not gonna fulfill the lust of the flesh. You're not gonna walk around here uncircumcised. You understand? You're gonna walk in the Spirit. You're gonna walk in the Spirit of the circumcision. That is to say, your mind is gonna be free from the sins of the flesh. You're not gonna perform those things. You're not gonna do those things unto man. Read on.
For the flesh lusts against the Spirit,
uh-huh,
and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. But if ye be led of the Spirit, ye are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery,
physical. Read on.
Fornication,
physical.
Uncleanness,
physical. That's sodomy. But anyway, physical.
Lasciviousness.
That now you're getting into spiritual, because that's to cause someone to lust. Read on.
Idolatry.
Uh-huh.
Witchcraft. Hatred.
Spiritual. Oh, here we come into all of these spiritual things. Now, see, these are the hidden things inside a man. Witchcraft. Witchcraft is wishing evil on people, conjuring evil things against people. People don't realize what real witchcraft is. Real witchcraft is being performed even in the sanctuary. We aren't listening because we don't know nothing. And we're not trying to know nothing because we won't obtain these things. We want to say, I'm a discerner of spirits, but then won't look and find out what these spirits are. You understand? How can you discern anything and you don't know nothing? You won't even look to take the time to pick up a dictionary and say, you know what, Lord, these things you said, I don't want these things upon me, so I better look these up to make sure that I can clean my soul. I can clean my mind. But you won't take the time to even open up a dictionary to do it. So we're not going to do it for you. We're just going to do some of it for you to show you how important it is for you to know. What it says, read that again. Idolatry.
Idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, seditions,
look up heresies. That word hatred, brother. Pull me that word hatred up here. Hatred. This is the one. I'm just going to pull one up so that you can go do your homework. And just who knows? Maybe you might pick up a dictionary and say, you know what, Lord? I don't want these things named, so I want to find out what these is, so these things are, so I don't find these things within myself, or I can protect myself from these things. That's what it is. Hatred. What it mean?
Abhorrence. Abomination.
It's in a what?
Abomination.
Hatred is abomination? Read on.
Alienation.
Uh-huh.
Allegory. Aversation. Bitterness.
Bitterness.
Coldness. Contempt.
So it's coldness?
Mm-hmm.
It's contempt. You can treat your brothers cold. You can treat them with contempt. That's hatred. Read on.
Detesting.
So you can look at somebody with detest in your eyes, like you something? Like you above anything in this life? In this world? When Jesus said it ain't none good but the Father? Who are you? Who are you? Read on.
Disapproval, disfavor, disgusted, displeasure, detest, enmity, envy, grudge.
So wait a minute, heavy hatred, envy, falling hatred?
Mm-hmm.
So wait a minute, man. So what it comes down to is that there's envy in there? What? Is envy inside of your hatred for someone else? And then it's a grudge there. Now you entertaining a foul spirit. But if you don't know what grudge means, you don't know. That's the thing. You got to look these words up, because these are the things that get you cut off. And if you don't look these words up, you're in trouble, because they in you. You are in the flesh. And he told us here, the works of the flesh are what? These. And if you're not looking these things up, you can get trapped pie. Why? Because that's your darkness, man. And if it's hiding in your darkness, you got a problem. You got a problem because you can't see your own self for your sins. Read on.
Okay. Hate, horror, hostility, ill will.
So you can wish evil on people. That's hatred. That's an evil eye. Ill will. The book called that an evil eye. Read on.
Malice.
There go that malice that he said, don't you take this Passover with this in you. But then again, now we finding out you can't take the Passover. You got any of that garbage inside of you. Read on.
Prejudice.
What?
Prejudice.
Yeah, so look at here. If you white and you call yourself a Christian, you got a problem with black folks, you got issues. And you're going to find yourself in a fire. If you black and you call yourself being hating white people, you got prejudice in your heart, you got issues. You're going to end up in a fire. It's just that simple because the Lord told you don't you even hide this prejudice in your heart. His kingdom is about the sons of Adam, not you. You understand? You're just a part of this creation. You ain't meant to be anything more or less. The thing about it is you just got a job to do. That's the end of it. And you don't do your job, got problems. You got to know what your job is. Therefore, you got to know what these things are. So people, when they start being bound by these things, or you can see these things up on people because you actually did the research. Now, you, when a person presents themselves, you see that spirit and you can identify it. And pray against it because you know. Now you can discern spirit because you did your homework. Read on.
Rancor, repugnance, revenge, scorn, spite. That's it.
Okay, scorn and spite. So scorn means to look down on somebody. All right, good. Now let's look at this 21 again and start that over.
20, envies, murders, drunkenness, reviling, and such like, of the which I tell you before, and I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Now, he said the works of the flesh are those. Now, if you ain't looking these things up, you don't know what society you people. Now, we just read one thing. We found out how awful that is. But guess what? I bet you 10 to 1, you done found one of those things that we read inside of you or maybe more. You understand? If you're really honest with yourself, you probably said, oh, man, that's my whole makeup. I better start praying that the Lord pull that garbage out of me. Thank you, Jesus, for revealing my secret faults to me. That's the key. Let's look at this a little further. Let's go into Proverbs chapter 26 and verse 20. Proverbs 26, verse 20. When you get it, go ahead. Because see, all these things is foul spirits, and we're not really paying attention to how deep this thing really run when it comes to when you're wrestling with devils or you're bound by devils. Now, this is the thing that the Lord talk about. You got to be careful of those that entertain devils or entertain spirits and unaware. They don't know that they're bound by spirits. They're entertaining them. But then again, they've been distracted by them, so to say. That's what entertainment means, distracted. Proverbs 26 and 20, and go ahead.
Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out.
Uh-huh.
So where there is no talebearer, the strife ceases.
Uh-huh.
As coals are burning coals to burning coals, and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife.
There it is. He said, as coals to burning coals and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife. Now, this person here, this is the Lord telling you, you have this inside of the camps. You have this person there. Now, if you don't look these things up, if you don't search these things out, these people will run rampant in the camps and will destroy people. Because they're righteousness isn't what they want it to be. So therefore, they got to tear people down because they not servants. Now, let's look at this a little further. Let's go in Job chapter 41 and let the Lord tell us what's really going on with this tail-bearing person. Job 41 in verse 1. When you get it, go ahead.
41:1.
Yes, sir.
Canst thou draw out Leviathan with a hook, or his tongue with a cord which thou lettest down?
So Leviathan is the serpent of the sea. Another word for Leviathan is Cadillac. That's the serpent of the sea. But then again, it only stands to reason, seeing that they cause are called what? Devils. Or we want to add a little French to it, devils. But no, it's devils. Think about it. Where are we?
Two.
Okay, skip down to verse. Yeah, read on.
Canst thou put an hook unto his nose?
Can you control his spirit? Read on.
Nor boil his jaw through with a thorn. Will he make many supplications unto thee? Will he speak soft words unto thee?
Now, once you call this spirit up and you start using this spirit, you think it's not going to turn around and rend you? Oh, yes, it will. Don't you? Skip down to verse 8 and 9 and go ahead. 9, verse 9.
Behold, the hope of him is in vain.
Satan, there's no hope in them. They done. They cut off, so they don't have nothing to lose. Read on.
Shall not one be cast down even at the sight of him? None is so fierce that dare stir him up. Who then is able to stand before me? Who have prevented me that I should repay him? Whatsoever is under the whole heaven is mine.
Look, even the fallen angels. But this is what people is dealing with. When you start that tail bearing and sowing discord, that's it. You messing around with devils. Read on.
I will not conceal his parts, nor his power, nor his comely portion.
I'm going to show him. I'm not going to conceal him from y'all. I need y'all to know this. This is what the Lord is telling us. I want you to know this so that you don't get bound by this spirit. Skip down to verse 19 and go ahead.
Out of his mouth go burning lamps, and sparks of fire leap out. Out of his nostril goeth smoke, as out of the seeth pot of cauldron. His breath kindled coals, and a flame goeth out of his mouth.
Ain't that something? Ain't that the same thing we read in Proverbs 26? That's what's coming out of the mouth of a talebearer. But then again, this is what's coming out of the mouth of devils. Now you know what that person is bound by. Now you can identify that spirit up on that person. That person ain't circumcised. That person is in the flesh. And that devil is running rampant through them. Now, go back to that Proverbs chapter 26. And let's pick it up at verse 20. When you get it, go ahead.
Where no wood is, there the fire goeth out. So where there is no talebearer, the strife ceases. As coals are to burning coals and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife. The words of a talebearer are as wounds, and they go down into the uttermost parts of the belly. Burning lips and a wicked heart are like a potsherd covered with silver dross.
Didn't he tell you that fire flames out of his mouth? Read on.
He that hateth disassembleth.
So now we found out he got hatred in his heart. Now we done found out what's really going on. Envy, strife, grudge, all these sort of things. Read on.
He that hateth disassembleth with his lips, and laugh up deceit within him. When he speaketh fair, believe him not, for there are seven abominations in his heart, whose hatred is covered by deceit. His wickedness shall be showed before the whole congregation.
Read on.
Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him.
Look at here. And you know, 9 out of 10, when they kick off that nonsense, it's going to backfire and blow up in their face. This is the whole thing. This is what happened with the servants of God. And this is the way of life. But these things are so. Wait a minute. How do you know that this won't happen to you? Go to St. Matthew's chapter 16 and verse 22. St. Matthew's chapter 16 and verse 22. Some of us will sit around and say, you know what? Hey, that ain't happening to me, and I ain't a part of all of that. Look, man, if you listen to anybody that's going on with nonsense, you are taking part in it, and you giving them fire. 16 and 22?
Yeah.
Read on.
Then Peter took him and began to rebuke him, saying, Be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee.
Look, the Lord just got to telling Peter he got to suffer and he got to give his life for us. Now, Peter just called God what? A lie. He just called him a liar. Read on.
But he turned and said unto Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan.
Whoops. Who is he talking to?
Peter.
Peter. The keys of the kingdom. So nobody is beyond that. Nobody. Nobody. That's why we got to protect our hearts, man. This is why you got to protect your mind. You got to know what these things mean so that you have. This is why he said you got to gird yourself, brother. You got to come on with the armor of God. You got to have you in the spiritual warfare. And it's for you and your salvation. Understand that. So he turned to he looked at Peter and saw the devil. That's what he really saw. Peter thought he was all up in love and whatnot. Pay attention. If it will rise up on Peter, it'll rise up on you. You got to protect yourself. But you got to know what these words mean so that you can protect yourself from this world. Read that again.
But he turned and said unto Peter, Get thee behind me, Satan. Thou art an offense unto me, for thou servest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men.
Okay, go to Jeremiah chapter 6 and verse 17. Jeremiah chapter 6 and verse 17. And when you get it, go ahead.
Also, I set watchmen over you, saying, Hearken to the sound of the trumpet, but they said, We will not hearken.
He said preachers to tell us these things, but we will not listen. What are these watchmen? Moses to John. Read on.
Therefore hear ye nations, and know, O congregation, what is among them.
Which is what? Which is what?
Among them.
Among them. He said, listen, you congregation. Listen, Israel, and know what's among you. Read on.
Hear, O earth, behold, I will bring evil upon this people, even the fruit of their thoughts, because they have not hearkened unto my words, nor to my law, but rejected it.
There it is. He said, I'm going to deal with their thoughts. This is what he said that's among you. Your thoughts is out of control. And it's we haven't brought our minds and our thoughts up under the subjection of God. We haven't humbled ourselves to his throne and to his feet. We have not. We have not sought the Lord, man. For real, when the last time we sought the Lord on our bellies with tears crying before our King? Not because we didn't done something wrong, but just because. When last time you done that? If you ever. Huh? But that woman covered Jesus' feet with tears and ointment, didn't she? But then he talked about that. He said, but you haven't covered my feet at all. And you know the law. And you know, you're supposed to know God. How come you ain't blessing me like this? But then he told him, he said, hey, guess what? The harlots and the sinners and the publicans are going to get in the kingdom and you're going to see them and you will not. Oops. Didn't know. That's when he said, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Understand that. He wasn't talking to the world when he said that. He was talking to his disciples. Those that know Jesus, those that know God, those that know his laws. He wasn't referring to the world when he said that because they ain't casting out devils. He told you that Satan ain't going to divide his house.
Read on. Are not acceptable, sacrifice sweet unto me.
Look at here. He said, now your sacrifice and your sweet incense is not acceptable unto me. Why? Because he said your prayers and your prayer, because you forsook the law, your prayers are what? An abomination. What is he talking about, this sweet incense? Go to Revelation chapter 5 and 8. Revelations 5 and 8. When you get it, go ahead.
And when he had taken the book, the four beasts and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them harps and golden vials full of odors, which are the prayers of saints.
And he said, therefore, your sweet incense don't sound, ain't nothing to me now. He's saying, now your incense is nothing. This is the whole thing. Now your prayers is nothing. They are abominable. That's that thing. Let's look at this a little further. Go into Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 5. In fact, Proverbs chapter 28. Proverbs chapter 28 and 4. Let me read that. Proverbs chapter 28 and 4. Proverbs 28 and 4, when you get it, go ahead.
They that forsake the law praise the wicked.
And then we love that too, man. We love that. We'll sit up here and we'll break all his commandments and talk about all these entertainers. You understand? We do that. Read on.
But such as keep the law contend with them.
And try to keep them on the path. That's why he said, I said, watchmen's over you. Read on.
Evil men understand not judgment. But they that seek the Lord understand all things.
Evil men don't understand judgment because they're not looking at these things and saying, you know what, do I sow discord? What do discord mean to me? You understand? Am I out here being a talebearer? What do that mean? They ain't even look these words up to even see if these are the things that they're performing onto themselves, onto other people. You understand? That they may save themselves. Read on.
But the poor that walk in his uprightness, then he that is perverse in his ways, though he be rich, whoso keepeth the law is a wise son. But he that is a companion of riotous men, shame his father.
Skip down to 9 and go ahead.
He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer shall be abomination.
Look at here. This is the thing where the Lord is talking about the prayers of the saints and that golden incense. He said, I'm not even hearing that. That's what he said in Jeremiah. He said, I'm not even hearing your prayer. I'm not smelling it. This is what he told the wicked out here. He said, you sitting up there, you eating pork and all this type. Your prayers are smoking my nose. I'm not hearing it. All right. Let's look at this a little further. Let's go into Jeremiah chapter 17 and verse 5. Jeremiah 17, verse 5. When you get it, go ahead.
Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man and maketh flesh his arm and whose heart departeth from the Lord.
Cursed is the man that put his trust in man. Don't even trust yourself. You a man. You created in the image of man. Don't trust yourself. Read on.
For he shall be like the heath in the desert, and he shall not see when good cometh, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness, in a salt land, and not inhabit it. Blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is.
Look at here. He ain't trusting in flesh, brother. He's trusting in the Lord. This is that thing. This is what the Lord have us to do. Read on.
For he shall be as a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out her root by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh, but her leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought, neither shall cease from yielding fruit.
Come on.
The heart is deceitful above all things, and desperately wicked. Who can know it?
He said, look here, the heart is deceitful above all things, and what? Desperately wicked. Who can know it? This is that thing. You got to understand this. This is what's inside of us. The Lord is telling us our minds is desperately wicked, man. But without the circumcision of the heart, can't serve God. That's what he's telling us. Read on.
I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins, even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doings.
He said, I, the Lord, do what? Search the hearts. I'm searching the minds. I'm searching what's going on inside of you. I'm trying to see if you didn't clean your head up. This is the thing that the Lord is saying to us. I, the Lord, search the hearts. I ain't forget what you're talking about you done. I'm looking inside of you, man. I want to see if you're right. And if you got this wickedness running on in your mind, and if you perform a wickedness out here after you done thought it out. That's what he's saying here. Jeremiah chapter 4 and verse 1. Four and one, when you get it, go ahead.
If thou wilt return, O Israel,
if what?
If thou return.
Other words, we ain't standing with a mob. He said, if you return, read on.
Saith the Lord,
uh-huh.
Return unto me, and if thou wilt put away thine abominations out of my sight, then shalt thou not remove.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt swear, the Lord liveth in truth, in judgment, and in righteousness, and the nations shall bless themselves in him, and in him shall they glory. For thus saith the Lord to the men of Judah and Jerusalem, break up your fall ground and sow not among thorns. Circumcise yourselves to the Lord and take away the foreskin of your heart.
He says, circumcise yourselves unto the Lord and take away the foreskins of your heart so that the Holy Spirit can dwell in you. Read on.
Ye men of Judah and inhabitants of Jerusalem, lest my fury come forth like fire and burn that none can quench.
Okay, good. Now, with that being said, we want to thank you for your time. We hope we edify somebody from myself here, Pastor Moore, my brother here, Pastor Nehemiah. We want to bid you peace in the name of Jesus. And as we say here at Come and See Ministries, read your Bibles. We thank you for your time.
He woke me up this morning, yesterday. So you know who